The Minnesota Media Archive is brought to you by North Metro TV. Your support helps make the archive possible. Please consider a one-time donation. The past comes alive at North Metro TV, where we can help you transfer your old videotapes, films, cassette tapes, record albums, and even photographs and slides to DVD and digital so you can enjoy them again. North Metro TV, bringing the past to life.
Centennial Tournament semifinal round, Wiper Lake. Nobody scores until the third period. Kerry Keeger's shot, Sarah Topol puts it in at 10:28. Wiper Lake gets on the board, they're winning 1-0. But it only took 1 minute for Centennial to score right back. Lisa Zewers finds Jamie Sincata, who finds the top shelf. It's a goal tied up at one. No one scores for the rest of regulation. We're going into overtime. Plenty of shots in the overtime, but plenty of stops. This shot goes off the pipe. Kelly Nelson, they get another chance at it. They wrap around, they can't get it in. And then a big hard slap shot from Megan Sandell. Sarah's Weber in net for the Bears. Having a huge game. At the other end, Alana McCready stopping everything that comes her way. Wiper Lake puts a scare of less than a minute left in overtime, but Centennial holds off. It's Alana McCready and Sarah's Weber. The big showdown. We're going to a shootout. Jamie Sincata, Centennial? No. Wiper Lake, Kerry Keeger? No. Megan Sandell? No. Kayla Hill? Denied. Lisa Zewers, no soup. Sarah Topol for White Bear Lake, yes, she's a scorer. White Bear Lake takes the 1-0 advantage in the shootout. With Sarah Weber playing such a great game, can Centennial score? Kelly Nelson says yes. Goal, Centennial ties it up right back, 1-1. We come back the other way, White Bear Lake for the lead, no. Centennial for the win, Teresa Gindin, no. We go into an additional shootout. Mysterious number 27, denied. Alyssa Trinkle for Centennial, no. Laura Triplett, there's only one of them. Maybe if she had two sisters, but no. Jenny Armstrong, yes. Jenny Armstrong gets the goal, a 1-0 lead in the second shootout for Centennial. White Bear Lake comes with Christina Thurmer, and she's denied by McCready. Melissa Shimoleski for the win. She says yes. Centennial wins in the shootout. They move on to the finals in their own Centennial Holiday Hockey Tournament to play against Hill Murray coming up here on North Metro 15.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome to Centennial Sports Arena here in Circle Pines, Minnesota, where the Centennial Cougars will be facing the Pioneers of Hill Murray. Centennial sitting at 11-1-1, the Pioneers at 9-3 on the season. And Matt, we should see a pretty good game tonight. The Cougars, one of the best defensive teams in the state, and the Hill Murray averages 8 goals a game in their 9 victories. Look for them to come out on the offensive attack.
Yes, very much so. Like you were saying, Hill Murray, a huge offensive team. But with Alana McCready in net for Centennial, she's just the one to stop it for him. She ended up helping Centennial to a win in a double shootout on Saturday night to advance onto this championship game in their holiday tournament. In that game, White Bear Lake came out in the third period with a goal halfway through with their top scorer, and then Sincata, the top scorer for Centennial, came right back and answered within a minute.
a heck of a game, definitely. You saw, again, like you said, a White Bear team that was very strong defensively. And, again, Centennial averages less than 2 goals a game allowed, so their defense is pretty strong as well. Last night, again, you mentioned McCready shut out through the first two, almost three periods. And the Cougars' defense is definitely going to have to play at least as well as they did last night against the Hill Murray team. Like I said, scores a phenomenal 8 goals a game in their 9 victories. They have just 3 losses on the year. And a Hill Murray team is going to come out quickly. They're going to be attacking early in the game. And, again, whoever gets that momentum early is going to have the advantage.
Yeah, in those losses that you mentioned for Hill Murray, they only scored 4 goals total. So if Centennial can manage to shut them down, they'll have a very good chance of winning this game.
I got a chance to talk to assistant coach Gary Vold just a few minutes ago, and we're going to take a look at an interview with Coach Vold. I asked him a few questions about tonight's game and how the younger players on the JV team will influence the future of Cougar hockey. Good evening, everyone. We're here live at the Centennial Sports Arena where the Lady Cougars, sitting at 11-1-1 in the season, are about to take on a tough 9-3 Hill Murray team. I'm here with assistant coach Gary Vold. Vold, what do you expect tonight from the Lady Cougars?
Well, I'm sure we're always excited to play Hill Murray. They've got a great team. We've got 3 strong lines. We usually don't have to get the girls up to play Hill Murray, so it's going to be a tough game.
Hill Murray's averaging 8 goals a game in their 9 wins this season. How are you going to stop that strong offensive attack?
Well, you know, we did well against Hill Murray last year, and I think this year we've got strong goaltending. I think we have a pretty aggressive forecheck that we've developed with the kids this year. So I think we're just going to play our game, play our style, and be real aggressive with them. I think we'll do all right.
You had a pretty physical game last night against the White Bear Lake team, who you guys were pretty heavily favored, but they came out and they gave you a shootout. How is that long game from last night going to affect your players today?
Well, we thought the girls looked tired yesterday. They looked tired in their first game. They feel a lot better today. You know, it was a long game. Our goalie was real excited about the shootout. She likes doing that. So I think it fired our girls up.
Coach, you're also the head coach of the JV team. Can you tell me a little bit about how the younger girls are getting ready to prepare to play on this varsity team?
Well, we have a real strong U14 team, and we would kind of like to see more of those ninth graders come out with the JV. But we've been running our JV and varsity practices together, which really improves our JV. And we started out kind of slow this year, but our JVers are playing real strong right now, and we've got a lot of the girls that are fighting for positions on the third line. So we're pretty excited about what's coming up and the progress of our team.
Emily Oss is starting tonight at defense as a freshman. How have you had a chance to work with her, and why is she getting the starting spot tonight?
Well, Emily's is a real smart hockey player, and she's young and she's making the young mistakes right now, but she's got a lot of confidence in herself, and she's a good hockey player. We've got a couple other girls just like her, so she's kind of gotten the nod right now, and if she can keep playing well, she'll stay there.
All right, thank you very much for your time, Coach. Good luck tonight. Matt Johnson reporting live from the ice. Send it back up to Matt in the booth.
Yeah, that was a great interview right there. Thanks for Gary Vold for taking his time and giving us an interview. One thing I'd like to mention about Hill Murray is that they're a very high-scoring team, but also they share their goals between four people. 3 of them are tied with 10 goals of Courtney Sinkovich, and you can see the hockey tournament right there, how both teams advanced into this championship.
Hill Murray, a very impressive win against Moundsview, 6-1. The Mustangs actually just defeated White Bear Lake in the third place game, 4-2. They are now the third place champions. Moundsview coming out to this tournament doing a good job, and the Centennial Cougars, I believe this is the second year in a row they've advanced to the championship game. I believe they lost the championship game last year, but as you mentioned before, a shootout last night against the White Bear Lake Bears, a team that came in with a losing record. But you know what? When two teams get together, anything can happen any day. A 4-2 win in a shootout. We will have more live from Centennial when we come back on North Metro 15. Good evening, everybody, and we are back once again at the Centennial Sports Arena, home of Cougar Hockey. The Lady Cougars tonight taking on the Hill Murray Pioneers, a team who we mentioned a couple times is a very high-scoring offensive team, and a pretty young team, too, man. It looks like they have a few younger starters tonight that will be coming out of the ice. I wonder how that will affect their play.
Yeah, I don't know. I also noticed that they also have a seventh grader on the roster. She's not starting, but we'll see if she'll be out there. Like you said, very young team. Not many seniors on the team. It's going to benefit them in the future.
Jessica Heron, as you mentioned, yeah, very young player. I see a lot. They have, I believe, two freshmen starting tonight. They have Katie Lawler's a freshman on defense, and also Kristen Peterson, a freshman as well. There's a look at Chuck a Puck. You can buy pucks here at Centennial Sports Arena and chuck them onto the ice and hope that your puck is the closest to the center. So you win. What do you win?
I believe you win some of the money that it costs to buy those.
Oh,
pucks.
Well, hey, we're going to have to do that. When does that come? I believe it's the end of the, is it the end of the first period?
It's the end of the second period when you throw them out there.
All right, well, end of the second period. The Cougars are coming onto the ice now, and they are about set to take on this 9-3 Hill Murray team. Coach Vohl, when I talked to him before the game, seemed very confident, Matt, and his team coming out strong early.
Yeah, you have to expect that they're going to be fired up for that shootout victory, double shootout actually, victory that they had over White Bear the other night.
Something they certainly didn't expect. A White Bear team, I believe, came in at 5-7, 5-7-1 in the year, and Centennial a pretty heavy favorite. And they had a test last night. And again, you know, Hill Murray should be coming out of the ice pretty soon, and here they come as they prepare to take on a Centennial team who is atop their North Suburban Conference with their record of 11-1-1. The leading scorer for Centennial is Jamie Sincotta. She has 11, more than, she scored one last night, didn't she?
Yes, she did.
So 12 goals on the year, so definitely look out for her in the number four in the white. And Hill Murray's leading scorer, Courtney Sekovic, the senior.
And we're about to get the starting lineups here.
Now, starting lineup for the visiting Hill Murray Pioneers.
And here they are. In goal, they have Emily Brookshaw. And Kelsey Fletcher is on defense, actually. And Katie Lawler is the other defense. And Kirsten Peterson is at wing. Nicole Rollins is at the other wing. And I'm guessing probably your sister at center, Monica Rollins.
Looks like it.
And you can see there that Emily Brookshaw, she is only allowed 1.33 goals per game.
Pretty low average. The entire Cougar team averages 1.36, so two pretty good defensive teams. Here's a look at those Cougar starters. The center, Jamie Sincotta. Elisa Zewers, who we talked to last night at right wing. Megan Sandel of left wing. Jenny Armstrong, one of the defenders. The Emily Oss on defense is a freshman, as we mentioned. And Alana McCready in the goal, who last night allowed no goals through nearly three periods, Matt. And as we take a look at the rest of the Cougar starters.
Yeah.
This is Jamie Sincotta. They just announced her name. And not a lot of Cougar fans here tonight. Again, we have the boys playing in the XL. Here's a look at McCready's stats in the season. In 535 minutes, she's allowed just 17 goals, averaging 1.62. And we are set for the anthem. Well, let's have a listen.
Bye.
right, Matt, we are just about set to go here. And as I mentioned just a few minutes ago, not a lot of Cougar fans, but they've sure filed in the last couple minutes here. We should have a decent matchup. There's a few Hill Murray fans. They're not too far away, so making the trip over here to see the championship game of this tournament.
Yeah, this is going to be a big game. The last game that Centennial had, they were really outnumbered by the fans. And like you said, they're pretty even here tonight. Not going to be too much of a home ice advantage for them.
Yeah, you would think the Cougars hosting their own holiday tournament. They've done it for several years. And as I mentioned a few minutes ago, the boys are playing down at the XL Energy Center tonight. They used to have their holiday tournament here as well, but just when the XL Energy Center went up, they have moved the tournament down there, a much bigger tournament. And so the Cougar boys are there, so possibly a few less fans here, but certainly the atmosphere is going to be pretty wild with a championship game. And you got to imagine the players are going through a lot of different emotions right now getting ready for this one.
Oh, yeah. Last night when they gave up that first goal of Centennial gave up, they did a great job of coming back, though. I thought that they probably would have got down on themselves, but they stepped up and scored that goal.
Yeah, they sure stuck it out through the down to the last minute. And let's look at Jamie Sincato. Has 12 goals in the year and 14 assists. We mentioned her before. Look out for her, number 4. In the white jersey for the Cougars. A look at the goalie, Alana McCready. Had a great game last night, allowing no goals until 6 minutes to go in the third.
Yeah, and that one goal she gave up, it wasn't much her fault. She tried to cover the puck up and got knocked in.
We are set for hockey now at Centennial Sports Arena, home of the Lady Cougars, who are looking to win their own tournament, the Holiday Classic. Here at home, they try to get something going down in the Hill Murray zone early. And again, watch out for Hill Murray's strong offensive attack. The Cougars will be playing very aggressive defense tonight to try and hold them. But as we learned last night, it's not often you see what you expect. You expect something, but certainly anything could happen, Matt.
Oh, yeah. I expect to see Centennial to come out strong, not only defensively, but also offensively, because some people say the best defense is a strong offense.
Very true, Matt. Good point. And they are down in that Hill Murray zone right now. Sincata behind the net trying to get a pass up top. She can't find one, and the Hill Murray Pioneer defenders are there. Hill Murray moving up the ice on the near side. Puck taken by Fletcher. She tries to move it down, and the Cougars are able to clear it behind their own net with just a minute gone in the opening period.
Yeah, Centennial, they controlled in the zone for a while, so when Hill Murray did manage to get the puck, they had to send it down ice to get a line change.
The Cougars changing up the line once again here, getting some new defenders in the game. I mentioned earlier, Courtney Sekovich for the Hill Murray Pioneers is their leading scorer. She did not start, but look to see her soon on this Hill Murray line. She may even be up there now. Number 21 in the green. She should be coming out of the ice pretty soon, you would assume, as their leading scorer, and now she does.
Yeah, Hill Murray has a couple other players tied with 10 goals in Colleen Conway and Nicole Rawlings. And Monica Rollins has 9, so they do like to share those goals.
In the first 2 minutes of this game, man, I'm seeing a lot more crisp passing than we did last night. The Cougars trying to get something going early. Hill Murray here now has the puck offensively and just slapped away by the tough Cougar defense. They're going to have to play good defense all night in order to keep themselves in this game.
Yeah, you mentioned the pass and said Hanel's going to have to do a lot of puck control, not give up many turnovers in their zone.
Conway almost had a one-on-one shot there. She couldn't quite get it off as the Cougar defense stood up. They'll now try to make their own drive. They need to find a pass. And across the they'll get a shot on goal, I believe. But Sincata right there in the near side of the net couldn't quite get it through.
Yeah, I was surprised on how I think that was Sandell who got that pass through to Sincata to let her deflect it on net.
In the first couple minutes here, I've seen Colleen Conway, number 3 for the Hill Murray Pioneers, playing very aggressively, very fast skater. Speed is definitely something you need to use as many times as you can. They get a shot on goal here. Excellent save by McCready.
Yeah, Hill Murray doing a good job of hitting those rebounds when they're coming. McCready's going to have to limit the rebound opportunities she gives up.
Sincata chasing for the Cougars on the near side in the corner. Back to Hill Murray. They'll get a shot, but it's deflected on the near side right here in front of us by Megan Sandel. Good job defensively for the Cougars early as McCready makes another easy stop.
Yeah, she's a very solid goaltender. She hasn't given up, many goals, and she makes the stops that needs to be made.
Big faceoff now in the Cougar zone. Taking it for Hill Murray is number 19, Valerie Rodriguez. And Hill Murray fails to control. Something we saw last night with the Cougars is that they had trouble controlling the faceoff. Both them and White Bear Lake couldn't really do it, but that's going to be a key tonight. It looks like Hill Murray's done a better job of it so far.
Yeah, the other night, those faceoffs, they'd come and they just bounced around off a lot of sticks, and Centennial having a tough time trying to get this
puck out of their zone. A little pushing and shoving going on the far side. Again, checking is not legal in girls hockey, so don't be surprised if you see a whistle later in the game. The referees last night they were pretty flexible.
Yeah, I've seen a lot of no calls. They're letting these girls play most of the time.
Certainly. The Pioneers now trying to set up their offense. Two of their own players fighting for control of the puck. Conway comes up with it and will clear it down behind the net where McCready takes it. She's got to get back in the goal as the Pioneers are taking a shot. Conway just left of the goal. Excellent stuff.
Yeah, Hill Murray's doing a pretty good job in making Centennial look unorganized there on defense. They're running into each other, not knowing who should be where.
Hill Murray still down in the Cougar zone behind their net with 12 and a half minutes to go here in this first period of play from Centennial, home of these Lady Cougars. They'll now try to clear it out as both teams have been playing very evenly through this first few minutes.
Well, I've seen a lot of what I saw in the other two games for Centennial, not much control in the opponent's zone. They do early, but then after the first minute or so, they start giving it up, and there's lots of face-offs and time in their own zone.
We have an icing call with 12:27 to go on the clock, and as you see, Hill Murray already has three shots on goal. The Cougars have yet to get a shot on goal, and I've noticed the result of those three shots on goal is crisp passing, and that's something you always have to have in any hockey game is really good passing, and Hill Murray's been better at that so far, but now the Cougars have a shot off the faceoff down in the Hill Murray zone, but again, they can't convert.
Yeah, Hill Murray's done a good job moving around the ice without the puck receiving those passes, like you said. They just know exactly where to be.
The Cougars now offensively trying to get something going. It's Kaylee Nelson, clears it out behind the net. Taken back by Hill Murray's Rawlings. Across center ice, they will try to set up their offense again. Great passing inside. Here comes number 16, once again, Nicole Rawlings. Behind the net, will not get a shot off. And she was helped out by Monica Rawlings, her sister. In front of the Cougar bench, they try to clear it out, but again, Hill Murray's there.
Yeah, Hill Murray, every time that puck gets into the neutral zone or into their own, they quickly control and bring it back into Centennials here for the past few minutes.
Cougars down in that Hill Murray zone again. It's been a pretty even game. The Cougars still do not have a shot on goal. Hill Murray with four, the one they just saw there added to the tally. And here on the near side again, both teams fighting for the control. The puck clears out to the Hill Murray zone where they will try to clear.
Yeah, Centennial, they haven't been able to get a shot on goal as of yet. Every time, they haven't been able to control much in the offensive zone. Hill Murray's doing a good job of not letting them set up.
The Cougars now here trying to clear it out, but look at that. You gotta get the stick on the puck. Kind of a weak effort there to try and get the puck out of the zone. Yeah, possibly a little nerves coming here for the Cougars early in this one.
Yeah, she got lucky that Hill Murray didn't jump on that. You gotta, when you get a chance to clear the zone, you have to do it.
Same thing happened right there with Kaylee Nelson. She's a young player, sophomore. Possibly some early game jitters. A championship game, certainly emotions running high. Coming up and shooting is Hill Murray's Conway, I believe. Excellent stop by McCready. Yeah. Right there, McCready looked like she made an excellent save. The Hill Murray players kept playing aggressively, though, and couldn't quite get it in.
And again, because Centennial couldn't get the puck out of the zone.
We're going to take a look at a replay once again here. You'll see the shot coming here. McCready makes an excellent save, but the Hill Murray does not stop. They keep fighting and grinding, but McCready's there.
Yeah, that was actually Jessica Murphy who came in off the bench strong towards the net with that shot. She's another one of those freshmen for Hill Murray.
Another good save by McCready you saw there. And so far, McCready playing, she's had a lot of shots. She had six shots on goal already, and she's made them all. She stopped them all.
Yeah, she's doing a great job so far. She hasn't let up. She let up a couple of rebounds early, but those last few, she's been able to freeze.
Centennial fails to clear, and Fletcher gets a hold of the puck. Now the Cougars try to get it back, but again, here comes Conway, who's been very strong. The leading scorer behind the net is Sekovich. She'll try to get a pass up top, and she will. The Cougar defense is gone, and an excellent save by McCready. She makes the glove save after she stops it with a stick.
Yeah, Hill Murray tried to go around and get that rebound, but she didn't allow it. And here at Centennial, they're not being able to get the puck out of the zone. They're going to start getting tired and start losing who they're supposed to be covering here on defense.
McCready certainly has had her work cut out for her in the first 7 minutes of this game. Hill Murray again making an aggressive offensive move, just as we expected. And here come the Cougars now offensively. They need to get a pass, and they can't, so they just clear it out behind the net. And hustling down behind the net is Teresa Gindon, who had a pretty good game last night, her along with Trinkle, trying to make something happen behind the Hill Murray zone. And the Pioneers all over it again, Matt.
Yeah, I think Centennial, if they want to have a very good opportunity to win this game, they're going to have to score early against the Hill Murray team to be able to commit strictly to defense, because if they give up a goal early, they're going to have to take some chances on offense and create a chance for Hill Murray.
This passing by Hill Murray is absolutely phenomenal. I've seen some very good passes so far. It's a pretty exciting game. We're knotted up at zero right now, 8 minutes into the game. But they've passed the puck very well, and you can kind of feel that Hill Murray's going to get something going here pretty quick. They already have 7 shots on goal.
Yeah, Hill Murray with their passing, that's a sign of both good practicing and good coaching. They're coached by Shane Gray, is Hill Murray. So he does a good job in practice making sure they work on their passing.
Christy Smith, or excuse me, that was actually number 28, Melissa Shimoleski, who clears it out. And then Cougars will switch the line as Hill Murray tries to regain control behind their own net. Lawler across to her teammate, Kelsey Fletcher. Fletcher tripped up, no call, and some more pushing and shoving going on as the Cougars try to get a shot in front of the net. Oh, there was two players there, they couldn't get a shot. Excellent backhand effort, another stop by the Hill Murray goaltender, Emily Brookshot. Excellent job of stopping two quick shots on goal from the Cougars.
Yeah, Centennial, they got a couple of rebound opportunities, but they weren't set up in the perfect positions to hit those in. It took them a few seconds to get to the loose pucks.
They had two players right in front of the net, but couldn't quite get to the loose puck, as you mentioned, and that's going to affect you. You got to take advantage of any opportunity you can get, especially against a tough Hill Murray team like this, who you mentioned, they're going to have to score early.
Yeah, Brookshot, she was getting too much time to adjust to those rebounded shots.
The Cougars seem right now like they're just trying to get something going, anything to give them some momentum. Emily Danielson back in the game, now number 5, a junior forward, making a pass, and she will now leave the game.
Yeah, it looks like Centennial, these last couple possessions, they really want to drive towards the net and get one of those rebound goals.
Excuse me, Danielson still is in the game. She'll try and receive it up across center ice, and she can't clear it out. The Cougars across center ice. This is the part of the ice where they're having a tough time, Matt. They got to be able to clear it out or set something up offensively. It just seems like when they get to that red line, they can't get something going offensively.
Yeah, if they want to control it in the Hill Murray zone, they have to get the puck over the blue line with full speed and their skaters not having to worry about staying on sides.
Hill Murray will once again clear it. It's Kelsey Fletcher, who's had a great game on defense as a junior for Hill Murray. They'll switch their line while the Cougars will hold on as we have an icing call with just over 7 minutes to go. Matt, it's been a pretty aggressive first 10 minutes of this game. What do you expect to see in the next 7 minutes?
I expect to see a lot of the same aggressiveness on both teams up and down the ice. We've been seeing a pretty clean game, though, for how aggressive it's been. There's no penalties yet, and we hope to keep on seeing that.
Certainly a power play for Hill. If Hill Murray gets a chance to have a power play, I'm sure as offensively strong as they are, they're going to be pretty aggressive on the power play. Centennial, a player without a stick right now. That's number 13 for the Cougars, Emily Oss.
Yeah.
That freshman who we mentioned earlier in our interview with Coach Voldy said she's a pretty smart player, but she's made a few mistakes as a young player, so she's going to have to step it up tonight in this championship game.
Yeah, here, and like you mentioned with those penalties, the other night, Centennial only had a couple, but they were hurt by giving up a lot of momentum. I don't believe there was no power play goal scored against them.
Bridget Katz gets a chance in front of the Cougar net. She's now trying to wrap around. She can't find someone to pass it. She finally gets it in front of that. The shot and the save by McCready. The rebound, no good.
Oh.
The Cougars on fire defensively.
You saw that glove come out real quick right there. And she snagged it. That was going to go in. She was laying on her chest and somehow managed to grab that. But like I was saying, Centennial's done a good job of killing off penalties.
Look at this one more time. McCready, as she gets a shot from Bridget Katz, she tries to get around the back of the net. She finally finds a pass in front of the net. The shot, the save, McCready, the puck loose, and still makes a stop. Great job by Alana McCready.
Yes.
Centennial now behind their own net, trying to defend this powerful Hill Murray offense. The Cougars now controlling across center ice. It's a one-on-one, but the defense of Hill Murray is there. And now back to the Cougars across center ice, who will try to get their offense set up. Hill-Murray will change lines, just a play or two.
Yeah, I noticed the shots on goal right now are 10-2. Centennial, they aren't getting many shots, so when they get their opportunities, they're going to have to make them count. Where it looks like Hill-Murray, they just want to get as many as they can, and one or two of them may go in.
The feeling I get in this first 12 minutes is that the Cougars are not quite as aggressive right now as Hill-Murray is. They are playing pretty good hockey. Their defense is doing the best they can against a very strong offensive team as Hill-Murray, but the Pioneers certainly seem to have the momentum right now and the aggressiveness that's going to win them the game.
Yeah, I've seen Hill-Murray be pretty physical against Centennial. The other two games, Centennial would come out around the second period and start throwing their weight around, and it looks like Hill-Murray's coming out and doing it early against Centennial.
Last night, the Cougars very lax and physical, as you mentioned, that, you know, it was two and three-quarter periods almost that we saw a really aggressive team.
And look at the standings here. Centennial again, 11-1-1. They've done a great job. That one loss was on the road, and here they are at home. So
they are
hoping to stay undefeated at home.
North St. Paul was that one loss they had early in the season back in November. The Cougars now atop the North Suburban Conference, looking to stay there and looking to win their own holiday tournament. They finished second last year, I believe, and looking to take the trophy this year. The Cougars across center ice, Hill-Murray defending. And
like
Cougars
you mentioned before, Hill-Murray, they just won't let Centennial get into the zone.
Right there, they needed to get that pass, but looks like they were more focused on changing the lines and getting their offense set up. 4:45 to go in the first, and we will have a face-off coming down to the Hill-Murray zone.
You can see the classic Suburban Conference here. With Hill-Murray, they are third in the conference at 9-3, and North St. Paul and South St. Paul atop that.
So. North St. Paul at 13-2. That is the team that Centennial lost to, so a pretty good team that they did lose to. So not too far from being undefeated in the North Suburban Conference and overall. The Cougars here at home, they did get one more shot on goal. They now have three but are still trailing in that department. Hill-Murray coming back with the puck is Bridget Gatz, who had the shot before. McCready is there for another stop.
Yeah, very good. She made the initial save, and then she got the stick out there to prevent the rebound. Watch the replay here.
Bridget Gatz on the far side of your screen, kind of a long shot, but McCready is able to stop it.
See, she let that deflect off of her chest, and then she got the stick out there to not allow any of the Hill-Murray players' sticks to try and knock that rebound in.
Last night, that was something that the Cougars had some trouble with, is a bouncing puck around, the puck bouncing around in front of the net and not being able to defend it. But today, they definitely improved in that department.
Yeah, that was how Centennial gave up their goal, their lone goal in regulation, was because of a bouncing puck
on their own net. Again, Centennial trying to control. Hill-Murray gets it back to shot. The save. McCready is there. The puck's still loose, and the Cougars will clear. Excellent job by the Centennial defense. They'll have a one-on-two coming now. Can they get a pass? No, they don't. They change the lines and miss another opportunity. Two more shots on goal for the Pioneers. Dangerous.
Yeah, Centennial, they did a good job of reacting to that turnover in their zone. They're going to have to watch those. I mean, a lot of McCree, she's already made 13 saves. I don't know if she's going to be able to keep this up throughout the whole game.
Their other goalie is Jesse Hoska, the junior. So if it comes down to it, she may come in the game, but certainly McCready's been solid all season. You got to leave your number one goalie in there.
Well, they'll leave her in there if she's not letting anything in. But, I mean, if you give up, you know, 13 to 20 shots a period, one of those is bound to just fall in.
Very true. They've been very lucky so far. Their defense has helped her out a little bit, too. Some of the major the big defensive players that have stepped up are Jenny Armstrong and Emily Austin. The freshman's been played a pretty good period so far in the minutes that she's had. And with just under 3 minutes to go, one of these teams needs to step up and gain some momentum before the second period comes into play, and the Cougars have a chance. A shot! No goal! Excellent save by Brooke Shaw. Taking the shot for the Cougars was number 12, Lisa Zewers, the sophomore forward. And again, Brooke Shaw is there.
Yeah, that was a great chance for Centennial, and I think that's pretty much what they're going to try and go for, strong defense and hope to get broken play. And you can see there the shot. Actually, I believe it was taken by Sandell. Yeah, it was taken by Sandell, number 14. Let's credit her with that shot.
Centennial, another quick shot off the faceoff. Very good. Something they struggled with last night, as I mentioned before. And right there, they get the faceoff. They take a slap shot from nearly the blue line. But an easy stop for Brookshaw. The Cougars taking some shots. They now have six shots on goal.
Yeah, you've seen a lot more clean faceoffs for both teams. One thing that we saw in the other two games for Centennial is slow line changes in those faceoffs, and the referees started to seem to get a little annoyed by it last game, so let's hope they don't allow, hope Centennial doesn't get into that.
Lisa Rosardi took a shot from the blue line, but an easy stop once again for Alana McCready. And with 2:02 to go on the clock, we have another icing call. Shots on goal 14 for the visiting Pioneers, and the Cougars here at home have six shots on goal. They need to step it up. They've done a pretty good job in the last 2 minutes here. They had no shots on goal for quite a while, but certainly the last few minutes they've stepped it up a little bit.
Yeah, well, one thing I've noticed, that I think that their game plan is going to be is, like I said, they're trying to have as much defense as possible and maybe get a loose puck through the middle of the ice, and they can maybe get a break. That's where they've gotten most of their chances so far.
Sekovic and Conway controlled the faceoff. The Pioneers still trying to set up their offense in front of the Cougar net. Centennial is there defensively, and a nice stop there by Kaylee Nelson. She'll try to set up the offense as well. And transition hockey is something that both teams need to work on. They play good defense. They got to either decide to clear it out or set up the offense. It's very tough when you're trying to play good defense and set up that offense. You got to work on that transition. Both teams could step it up a little bit here with just over a minute to go.
Yeah, I definitely think Centennial needs to look a little bit more organized on their offense. They don't look nearly as well organized as Hill Murray. Every time Hill Murray has an offensive possession, they always seem to know where everybody is going to be.
Melissa Shemileski now trying to control. She gets it back behind the Pioneer net, but now Hill Murray takes control once again. They've had the control most of the tempo of this game. When the Cougars do have it on offense, it's usually a one-on-one opportunity. Like you said, they need to set up that offense, get a play in there, get something that's going to work out for you. And Hill Murray with a chance here just under a minute to go. Can they get another shot off? Cincotta clears it out defensively, but now Hill Murray right back in the zone. And they may get a shot with under a minute to go, Matt. And this would be a huge momentum switch if they can get a shot.
The line that was just out there for Centennial is going to be that line that they're going to look for offense, the three leading scorers on that line. So that's their big offensive line. It did start tonight. So
20 seconds to go. Hill Murray trying to make a move here on the road in the Centennial Holiday Classic. Time is ticking away. The Cougars will probably just clear it out here if they can, but again, Hill Murray's offense is all over it. Fletcher gets it across, and now back to the Cougars, who with just 5 seconds left will, I'm guessing, just run the clock, and that is what they do. Matt, a first period very intense despite no goals. 14 shots on goal for the Pioneers and 6 for the Cougars. What do you expect to see here in the second period coming up?
I think that Centennial is going to come out and, again, just stick with that defense. It seems to be working. I mean, they have been giving up a lot of shots, but they have gotten a couple of breakaway opportunities with that.
Their defense certainly has played well in the last few minutes of this first period. Matt and I will be back with more on North Metro 15 after this. How's it going, everybody? We are back here at Centennial Sports Arena, the home of the Lady Cougars, who are about to start the second period of play with the Hill Murray Pioneers, who have played a very aggressive offensive first half, just as we expected, Matt. Or first period, excuse me. And we look to see that again in the second period.
Yes. Yes, we do. One thing with this Centennial... Oh, well, you get the first period stats here. Centennial clearly outshot 14-6. Their only opportunities were on breakaway opportunities, or one-on-one breaks, two-on-ones.
Their first two shots came simultaneously, or right together, with about 3 or 4 minutes to go in the first period. So they kind of were a bit slow on the get-go, but they came back and had a pretty strong end of the first period. So hopefully they can move that into the second period as well and keep that momentum in their favor. No penalties in the first half, as you also saw in that graphic, something that could become crucial if there is a penalty. I'm sure Hillary's strong offense has been very, very aggressive. And if that, with the power play, they'd obviously have a better chance. We're going to look at a replay here.
I believe this is the
Cougars here with
to clear the puck and it got stolen away and they gave up a lot of opportunities.
I believe that was officially two shots on goal for Hillary right there. They had the rebound. A lot of McCready was all over it. Great stop by McCready, and the Cougar defense has certainly had their work cut out for them in the first period and should as we go into the second period here as well.
And now you see the Pioneers coming out on the ice. They seem to have always been on the puck wherever it was on the ice. Centennial seemed to be scrambling a lot on offense, and they had a couple of bad clearing attempts. You saw a replay of one of them there where they crossed it through the middle of their zone and it got stolen away.
Hillmurray's been very aggressive in this first half, but that Cougar defense that you see coming out of the ice right now has done a good job of stopping them. As we mentioned, for those of you just joining us, the Cougars allow just under two goals a game as a team. McCready allows 1.62 goals against. That's her average.
And you see Megan Sandel right there. She's got herself 4 goals and 10 assists. She skates on that line with Sincata and gets a lot of the assists to Zewers and Sincata.
Cougars a pretty high-scoring team themselves, but Hillmurray, an impressive stat that I noticed before the game, I mentioned it a few times, is in 9 wins that they've had this season, they are 9-3. In those 9 wins, they average 8 goals a game, with their highest being a 13-goal game in one of their earlier victories. So certainly an offense that Centennial's done a good job of holding to nothing here in the first period.
Yeah, Hillmurray also scored 6 in their last game in this tournament. They won that game 6-1 over Moundsview. And the other game they won in overtime, 3-2, so
they had a tough early test, but certainly have weathered the storm, and they are here, and they are playing for the championship trophy of this Centennial Holiday Tournament, a tournament that's been taking place for several years now, and we are happy to be here covering it once again for North Metro 15. The Cougars, I believe, got second place last season, the second place. The boys also playing in the tournament this weekend at the XL Energy Center, so the turnout here at Cougar Arena a little bit low, but certainly a good amount of Hillmurray fans here. We should have a pretty evenly matched second period of play.
Yeah, one thing that should be mentioned is Centennial, the other two games, they didn't score until late into the game, so they would normally come out defensively and just get the opportunities when they came. They wouldn't try and force anything until late in the game.
And as you mentioned before, they need to get that first goal. They need to get that momentum early in the game, and they're going to have to do it here quickly. They have struggled to get, keep their aggressiveness and to keep that strength going on in from period to period. They need to come out strong and stay strong throughout the full 3 periods to give themselves a chance. They need to get certainly more than 6 shots on goal.
Yeah, they need to really work hard on the offensive end. And like I had mentioned before, right there, you saw before that last faceoff, Centennial again taking a while to get out to the faceoff circle. And sometimes the referees, they'll drop it before Centennial's ready.
What a hit there. Number 19 for Hillmurray, taking a shot is Rodriguez to the Cougar defender. And Centennial and Hillmurray playing a very aggressive game so far. They've been very aggressive in the first period of play. And look for that to continue as that championship trophy is still in sight for both of these teams. As this game stays close, you'll see that intensity and a great save by Alana McCready.
Yeah, we're going to see a lot more great saves from Alana McCready if Centennial's going to win this game with those 14 shots to give up in the first period and now a couple of ones here in the second. She's going to have to keep on making some fabulous saves.
And a big face-off here for the Pioneers as they look to get that quick shot after the face-off. They do not, and the Cougars control. Good job by Centennial. Again, we mentioned they struggled with that, but they've been doing a much better job of it in this game. But now Hillmurray quickly takes it back, and they should get a shot, but the Cougar defense is there. And Sincata, the leading scorer, is going to clear it out here, take it all by herself. Sincata gets a shot and clears it off. Good job by Sincata getting the puck out of the zone.
Yeah, I think if it takes a while for Centennial to score here, I think Sincata is going to try and take it upon herself to get that goal like she did the other night against White Bear when they were down one she weaved through everybody and got a shot in.
So kind of the senior center for the Cougars, certainly stepping up, and they will miss her next year indeed. They do have a pretty good young team, as we learned from Coach Gary Vogel, one of the Cougar assistants, who is also the JV head coach. He mentioned they have a pretty good crop of young players coming up for the next few years. Look for this Cougar team to be strong for a long time coming. In the near zone, they're struggling here to clear it. They finally do. They got to set up that offense, Matt. We talked about that earlier.
Yeah. Well, like mentioning with that young team you're saying, the biggest thing that they have going for them is that Alana McCree is only a sophomore. So she still has two more years, the Centennial Cougar team.
On the far side, Hillbury behind the Cougar net looking for a pass in front. Will not, as the Cougars are there defensively. Very impressive Centennial defense we've seen through the first period and now into the first 3 minutes of this period. The Cougars now setting up their offense a little bit better, but again, a missed pass. Waiting to receive it was Katie Nelson. Couldn't quite get a hold of it.
A nice move right there you saw by Monica Rawlings, one of the big scorers for Hill Murray.
Rawlings, a junior center for Hill Murray, and certainly she's had a good game so far. We've seen some of the major plays Hill Murray's had, some of the scoring opportunities they've had. She's been there and very close to another shot there.
Well, one thing that Centennial does have, even though they haven't been getting a great offense, they have not allowed a goal, so they've been managed to stay in this game, and the longer they do, I think the more confidence they're going to get.
Very good point, Matt. The Cougars now cleared as they play good defense. Number 12, Kristen Peterson, had a chance there for a shot, but she couldn't find a pass, and the Cougars successfully clear with just over 13 minutes to go on the second period clock.
Yeah, this is about the fifth face-off in the Centennial zone. They've done a good job of not letting Hill Murray get a clean win on any of these face-offs. That's more of the important thing when it's in your zone. If you don't win it, make sure that it's not a clean win for the opponent.
Centennial controlling their second consecutive face-off, and look at them go down the ice with it. Excellent work by Lisa Zewers, who we got a chance to talk to a little bit last night, and she continues to control the puck all by herself. She needs to find a pass to cause in front of that. She can't get there. The shot, and an excellent save by Hill Murray's defense, and they go!
That was one of the few rebounds given up by
Lisa Zewers. Lisa Zewers is there with the rebound. We'll take another look at it here in just a second. Jenny Armstrong was also there on the assist. Lisa Zewers with the shot and the goal. Her seventh goal on the season. Lisa Zewers, the forward for the Cougars, is there and puts them on the board. And as we mentioned, they needed to get that first goal to have the momentum, and they did it.
Yeah, and again, it was that line with Sincata and Zewers and Sandell on it that they looked for the goals. They got a nice rebound opportunity that Brookshot gave up, where Alana McCready, her counterpart in net, she has done a great job of not allowing many of those rebounds in, or rebounds at all, actually.
Good point, Matt. Again, the assist officially went to Sincata, so Sincata, the leading scorer, gets another assist on the season, and excellent job by the Cougars getting on the board early in the second period where anything could have happened. They came out strong early, just like we mentioned they had to do, and they did. They were successful.
Yeah, I think this is going to help their defense a lot, because now they can sit back and not have to worry about getting down the ice and setting up their offense. You can see the replay here of the goal. The miss passed through, but a nice job by the defense defender up there. And Brookshaw, she stopped the initial shot, but none of her defenders was there to clear the puck out of the crease for her. It was a little bit of a breakdown of the Hill Murray defense.
After that initial shot, as you mentioned, Zewers had a pretty wide open net right there, but an excellent job of Zewers by being there at the right time, putting the Cougars on the board 1-0. That goal came at 4:15 in the second, 1-0 Centennial, and now they're in front of the goal again. Sincata there trying to find a pass. Zewers also there again, but Hill Murray defends a little bit better that time, and they will try to take control now across center ice. It's a one-on-one. Monica Rawlings, we mentioned before, will take the shot of the save.
Well, like you had mentioned about the rebound with Zewers being there, in that first period you saw a couple opportunities where there were loose pucks with open nets, and none of the Centennial players were there. They must have talked about that in the intermission in the locker room, saying when you get the rebounds, you have to be set up.
Here's another look at that shot. Rawlings coming up. She has a wide-open shot, but again, Alana McCready, the sophomore goalie, is here. So again, as you said, she'll be here for a few years. The Centennial team, a pretty average team. You know, not too incredibly young, not too old. So they should have a few of their their stars out here for a few years to come.
Yeah, they're pretty balanced, and that Northern works out a lot better. We had mentioned that Hill Murray is young. We're going to see how they react to being down here when they were probably pretty close to favorite, at least with their offense. But now they're down. Let's see how the young players react.
11 minutes to go, second period of play from the home ice of the Centennial Cougars here at the Sports Arena in Circle Pines. The Cougars on the near side look to take control, but again, Hill Murray is there. They will clear successfully, and both teams will change lines quickly.
Yeah, the reason I had mentioned about how Hill Murray reacts, the other night when Centennial got down early, the senior Sincata, one of the big leaders on their team, stepped up and scored the game-tying goal to allow them to go into overtime. See if they can, if Hill Murray can find somebody to do that for them.
And now Hill Murray again with control of the puck, and they're looking to set up their offense. Something that, as we mentioned earlier, their passing has been incredible throughout the first period, and so far the second period has been pretty good too. And the Cougars certainly playing a little bit more aggressive in this second period by scoring that first goal. Now Hill Murray with the shot, and a save by Lana McCready. How did she do it?
I don't know. She just saw that pass from a mile away, apparently, and reacted right to it.
Look at it one more time. This is an excellent save. Hill Murray barely regains control. Courtney Sekovich, the leading scorer, gets the pass off. The shot, an excellent save right there is Alana McCready. The shot taken by Colleen Conway, the junior forward for the Pioneers.
Again, McCready doing a great job not allowing rebounds. That's how a lot of teams get their goals, is on the rebounds, not so much on the initial shot.
Very true. You got to make sure that puck does not bounce around in front of the net, and McCready did a great job of it there. They'll clear it here. We'll have an icing call with 10:01 on the second period clock. As we have a second, I'd like to mention that we will have Chuck a Puck coming up after the second period of play, Matt, and we at North Metro 15 bought some pucks. We are ready for Chuck a Puck. We'll be coming up 10 minutes from now, so be sure to stay tuned after the second period for Chuck a Puck. North Metro 15 will be throwing pucks onto the ice for the first time. We want some money.
Yeah,
we want some new headsets, We could use some equipment. McCready there on the save again as Hill Murray looks to regain control. And here comes Lisa Zewers, the star of this game so far for Centennial. She gets tripped up, and now Hill Murray will clear.
Yeah, one thing I wanted to mention about the passing that you had mentioned about Hill Murray, they've had very crisp passing for Centennial, someone hasn't, but actually the missed pass is what set up their goal. So sometimes it's not always connecting on the passes that work out.
Very true. Anything you can do to get on the board will definitely be advantageous. 9.5 to go, second period of play, and both teams will switch up lines on the break from the icing call. Hill Murray will have a very important faceoff in front of the Cougar net.
Yeah, like I was saying earlier, Cougar's doing a good job of not giving up free faceoffs here in their zone. Let's see, and they're tossing Ginden, who was set up to take that. I don't know if she tried to steal it earlier or something. But
Hill Murray controls here as they clear. We'll have another icing call.
Ooh, that was pretty close.
Yeah, I don't know.
But they're going to call it icing, so.
You'll notice that the Cougars now have 10 shots on goal to the 17. So, and this, it was what, 16-4 or 8 at the end of the first period?
It was 14-6 at the end of the first. So,
Centennial
doing much better early in this period, getting off a lot more shots. And again, it's the ones that count. They're shooting 10%, where Hill Murray is shooting 0.
Excellent aggressive effort there on the part of Hill Murray, diving after the puck as Courtney Sekovich couldn't quite get to it, though, as the Cougar offense looks to clear it out. Here's Sekovich once more. She's pushed down to the ice, but no call. Across 13 minutes of blue line, the shot coming, and they're looking for a goal in front of that. Sekovich is there, and McCready makes a stop. The rebound, nothing.
They blew the whistle for a cover up there on McCready, and they end up knocking it out from under her glove.
Look at it once more, Matt. You see the shot here.
They blew the whistle right then when she put the glove down and it got knocked out. So maybe a little bit of a premature whistle. I'm not sure, but
could have been dangerous. And now another faceoff now will come, and taking it for Hill Murray is Monica Rawlings for Centennial. Number 14, Megan Sandel, and the Cougars again controlling the faceoff, getting a clean pass up across center ice to Lisa Zewers, who has the lone goal of the game. Zewers will try to find a teammate to pass to as she's stuck up on the boards with the Hill Murray defender.
Yeah, well, one thing
fighting for the puck.
Well, one thing I've noticed with Hill Murray's lines is that with their balanced scoring, like Centennial, they have pretty much one line that they look to score, where Hill Murray has a couple of lines that have big scores on it, so that could come to benefit Hill Murray late in the game.
That makes that one goal for Centennial early in the second period even more important, because we know how strong Hill Murray's offense can be as they take another stab at it here. There will be no one to pass to up across the middle, so the Cougars defend as Hill Murray changes lines. The Cougars do the same.
Yeah, Sincata's line was out there for over a minute, so she had to get the line change out there.
Something nice about hockey, you always get new players in the game, and keep fresh legs in there and keep the speed of the game going. A trip there, nothing called, as a Cougar player is on the ice.
Yeah, again, we're seeing some pretty physical, and they're going to call this a penalty, I believe, yes. That didn't look nearly as bad as what Hill Murray had done to Centennial earlier in this play, but
let's look at this once more, Matt. You see the penalty that they're going to call here. It's on the Cougars.
Yeah, it looks like a little bit of a check there. She's been hitting a couple of people. Yeah, that is.
Here's one they called right there. You saw it in the last second on the right side of your screen there. We'll hear the official penalty here in just a moment. That is number 7 for Centennial. Alyssa Trinkle will be in the penalty box. It's a minor penalty. It's a slashing penalty.
I guess we didn't see the slashing. It was hidden by the boards, but there was. But like I was saying, I believe the it was Valerie Rodriguez who made the first hit on Centennial, and she's the one that took the slash, I also believe. She's had a couple of big hits against Centennial, but now we're going to see Centennial shorthanded.
Take that shot.
The Hillbury Pioneers now will get a shot, and McCurdy's there, the rebound, no goal. How
oh
the heck
my.
Did you stop that?
That thing rolled along the line. I saw it roll right along it. That was amazing.
Look at this, Matt. Her skate, I believe, was the last thing to stop it. I believe the shot, Conway gets a pass up to Sekovic. The shot is right there in front of McCready. Look at the puck on the middle of your screen there, rolling across the line, as you mentioned, and she grabs it with her left paw. What a stop by Alana McCready.
Yeah.
In a crucial point of the game where Hill Murray's on the power play. Wow.
I've seen a lot of McCready make some amazing saves but in this tournament, but I think that one right now is the biggest that she's made this entire weekend.
I definitely agree, but now Hillbury with another opportunity. The shot, the save, the rebound, nothing there. She barely got a hand on that. That could have been dangerous.
Yeah, there was Hillbury probably driving right to the net. McCready.
Look at this. Look at this play one more time. We're going to see who gets a shot. It's Hillbury's. Jessica Murphy here, she'll take a shot. Excellent shot.
Hit but off the blocker you saw there.
As you mentioned, the rebound. Look, it's barely underneath her mitt, and that's what's the most dangerous, as you mentioned earlier, is that rebound.
Yeah, McCready's going to have to step up here for the next minute 20 left in this power play. You know Hill Murray's going to get a lot of chances with the way their offense is.
Exactly. Very high-scoring offensive attack they have. They get a shot here, and Centennial will clear. Cincata across their own blue line will now take it across center ice and clear it. Excellent job. She actually gets a shot. An effort there just to clear it, but she gets a shot on goal, so they will have a stop.
And she also followed in there, you saw, and got the freeze, so the faceoff is going to come in the Hill Murray zone, so that's going to benefit Centennial. It's going to, if Hill Murray even does win the faceoff, it's going to take him a good, 10 seconds to get back in the Centennial zone.
Very good point, Matt. We are under 7 minutes to go now in the second period of play in a game where Centennial leads 1-0. They are currently shorthanded. A minute left of the power play. As you can see in our squatch box, here comes Rawlings, Nicole Rawlings by herself. She will get a pass back up top. And she gets back up top to her sister. Here's Nicole Rawlings. They are trying to set up their offense. Whenever you see that it's just still for a while, you know they're having an easy time like you do right now, setting up their offense. They're just waiting for a pass, waiting for a shot. McCready stops it with 33 left on the power play now.
Yeah, Hill Murray's power play is very good.
Cincata shorthanded. Won't get a pass. Good defense.
Well, like I had mentioned before, the passing, and now you can see in the power play, that's a lot of coaching and practice that does that for them. And they're very crisp, but
Monica
doing
Rawlings,
a good job of killing off this penalty so far.
Monica Rawlings just got a pass off to her sister, Nicole. She had a shot just wide left of the goal. That one was pretty dangerous itself there as the Cougars look to kill the penalty with 5 seconds to go. Centennial will successfully clear it.
Centennial, full strength.
They're now full strength. A few shots on goal for Hillbury in that power play that were very dangerous, but McCready and the defense held them.
And you saw right there, they did get the clear. Not only when you kill the puck, you also have to get that, or you kill the penalty, you also have to get out of your zone to be able to adjust to what just happened.
A few players on the ice on the far side fumbling down, but nothing called. Once again, the referee is letting him play. We've had just one penalty in this game, as you saw. And now Hillbury, both teams at full strength, but they'll get a shot, and it's pretty wide.
Yeah, good back checking there by Centennial getting back on that play when it looked like it was going to be a 2-on-1, but I believe it was Trinkle who...
Ooh, there's going to be a penalty there. I believe we'll have slashing, do they call it, or a trip, I believe. We could see that on the near side.
I guess tripping. This is what Centennial had gotten in trouble with in the past couple games, is they kill off a penalty and then come back real quick with another one.
And right here you'll see there is a slash, there's a tripping penalty, and I believe it was on number 2, I want to say.
It's number 5.
Number 5, Amy Danielson, the junior forward for the Cougars, will be in the box for 2 minutes. Tripping is what they officially call it.
Yeah, and now Centennial, they have to go right back on the penalty kill. I mean, that was a tough 2 minutes for Alana McCready, and it's going to be another tough 2 minutes again here. They're asking a lot of her tonight.
So, Hillbury, once again, in that very dangerous power play opportunity. They had several shots on goal the last time they had the power play. The Cougars did kill it with no goals being allowed, but certainly McCready was in trouble. And another penalty coming.
This penalty is going to be on Hillbury, though. It's a delayed penalty on Hillbury.
Very shortly, we'll have a 4-on-4 coming, and another one, nothing called. The coaches on the Centennial side are furious. But now I believe it'll work itself out.
Yeah, the player that got knocked down there was Sincata, and it's always dangerous when you see her go down because, I mean, she's the one that Centennial always looks for when they need a goal.
The penalty on Hillbury is assessed to number 18, the junior center, Monica Rawlings. She'll be in the box 2 minutes. I believe it'll be for roughing.
Yeah, you saw her just throw her right down there in that replay. She just...
Holding is the official call, as we saw there in the replay.
Well, I'd call it 2 minutes for tackling is what it looked like to me.
This is not a football game. Let's not talk about the Vikings right now. I don't know. Rough day if you're a football fan.
Well, it's going to be 4-on-4 here for a minute 26 and a short power play.
Look at this replay here. Sincata trying to
tackle. That was at the end of the play when Hillbury managed to get touched up to end that penalty. And Sincata, yes, got hit down very hard, but there's already a delayed penalty, so maybe the referees just decide not to call that one.
The 4-on-4, and Centennial controls the first faceoff of the 4-on-4. We have 4 minutes to go, by the way, and both teams again here in a very...
And you see number 4 out there, Sincata, is skating.
It's a very crucial point in the game right now with under 4 to go in the second period. You need to have that momentum going into the third. The Cougars have that one goal lead. We have another penalty called here. It's on number 3 for Centennial. That'll be assessed to Jenny Armstrong. Number 3, Jenny Armstrong, the penalty.
So now it's going to be, actually no, it's going to be on Lisa Zewers. She's the one going to the box.
They changed that. I believe the ref was pointing number 3, but we'll have Zewers. That's her second penalty on the night.
Yeah, so now it's going to be a 4-on-3 for 59 seconds, and then back to a 4-on-4.
It's a 5-minute major penalty. That will be huge for Hillbury. It's a 5-minute penalty, not your normal 2 minutes. That's 5 minutes. So Zewer's in the box for 5, one of their most intense players in this period, and now a 4-on-3 going. The power play for Hillbury, what an opportunity they have here to tie it up going into the third.
Yeah, Hillbury's going to have a power play for about 40 some seconds, and then they're going to be 4-on-4 for about a minute, and then back on the power play for about another 3 minutes. It's going to be tough for Centennial.
If they'll
be
on,
they'll be down the rest of this period no matter what, because with a major penalty, even if a goal is scored, you don't get your player out of the box.
Okay, good point. It's certainly going to be the determining factor of this game could come in the next 3 minutes. We have 3 minutes to go in the second period. Centennial with a one-goal lead at home. But now, Hillbury threatening, and she's stopped. Good defense by the Cougars. This could be the turning point. If the Cougars can hold on to either hold the lead or be tied going into the third, they should be pretty well off in the third period. But you got to hold on to that one-goal lead. Certainly trying to stop them for 2.5 minutes. It will be tough.
Yeah, in this, for the rest of the period, and there will also still be the power play at the beginning of the third. Alana McCready, she's going to have to step up for Centennial because, I mean, they're...
Oh! In front of the goal, but McCready made a stop. The Cougar defense was there to help her out as that was another dangerous opportunity. Look at it again.
Now watch this replay here. Got deflected out, and I don't quite know what they blew the whistle for. I mean, the puck wasn't frozen or anything, but... Yeah, up until now, we had a pretty clean game. Not many penalties, and then... It's about 5 minutes left in this period. Lots of penalties called.
And now we'll have a 4-on-4, as we mentioned, for 13 seconds. And then we'll be another power play going for about 3.5 to finish out the period. McCready with a save, the rebound, the shot, nothing there. She stops it. And number three was there is Colleen Conway, whose name we mentioned a few times, got the shot off the rebound. Let's take another look, Matt.
Hey, you see... On the power play, Centennial, they just are shorthanded. Centennial, they really need to
that
get
shot
to the puck.
Has to go in the net. She had a wide open opportunity. Conway versus McCready. And McCready wins the battle between the pipes. Excellent job by the goaltender for the Cougars.
Well, the referees, they seem to be having some pretty quick whistles here for Alana McCready. They've been blowing it when she hasn't completely frozen the puck.
Something that did not happen last night. You mentioned it's a very dangerous situation. That shot coming from the blue line, looking for a deflection in front of the goal, they couldn't quite get it. We are now under two to go in the period. The Cougars now we're 4-on-4. No, we're back to shorthand.
Yeah,
we are shorthanded for the next 2 minutes.
For the rest of this period, and then about a minute into the third period, they will be shorthanded, whether there's a goal scored or not, like I had mentioned, so.
Centennial will just about clear it. And Hill Murray now on the near side, looking to take control across center ice. And they do. Looking to set up their offense now. Here comes Sekovic. She can't find a pass. The Cougars clear it back up top, where it's taken by Fletcher.
Yeah, one thing that when Centennial kills this penalty off, you're going to have to look for that. They may get a little, like, they killed the penalty off and they don't have to worry too much. And that's when some goals come in. They aren't power play goals, but they are pretty much a result of the power play.
1 minute to go now in the period. 1 minute left in the second. And this could be the most crucial minute of the game. Momentum going into the third. A shot by Hillbury and an excellent stop before it could even get to the goal by the Cougar defense. They got to hold him for 43 seconds.
Saw Ginden right there. She was skating down that puck really hard, making Hillbury keep that puck in their own zone for quite a bit of this period now. She's doing an amazing job right there. You saw her. She wouldn't let Hill Murray get the pass out, and Centennial gets it right back in. A great job of killing off this penalty right now.
20 seconds to go on the game clock here from Centennial Sports Arena in Circle Pines, where the home team, the Centennial Cougars, are holding on to a 1-0 edge despite two late penalties in the second period. They've been able to kill them so far. Hill Murray with one last gasp here in the second period. They will not get a shot off as the Cougars hold the Pioneers in the most crucial point of the game. After they scored that first goal, they came back. Their offense was in check. Lisa Zewers made the goal, and they come back and play the most aggressive defense of the tournament to stop a very tough, high-scoring Hillbury team.
Yeah.
Excellent job.
And I really like the aggressive penalty killing they had at the end of that period. But we're going to have Chuck-a-Puck right here.
As you can hear from our PA announcer, we have our Chuck-a-Pucks here. And I was talking before the game to one of the girls that was selling the Chuck-a-Puck. Donations, it's what? It's $1 for a puck, $5 for six pucks. We purchased six pucks here at North Metro 15, and we are looking to win. We have numbers.
Well, we're going to have to get these out. We only got about another 25 seconds.
Let's go. See what kind of skills we have. Oh, that one's close. Get there.
I see the winner. If no one hits that thing, I think he's gonna win. It's dead center.
Come on, where's our Channel 15 pucks? We gotta win this thing. It's our first ever Chuck-a-Puck. Come on, baby. This is craziness. Pucks flying all over the place here at Centennial Sports Arena.
Yeah.
But our pucks, they need to be in the middle. They're not in the middle. What's going on, man?
Yeah, we didn't win that one.
We're rookies. We've never done Chuck-a-Puck before. Now we know how to do it.
Yeah, there's lots of strategy to this. I mean, do you want to be the first one to let that puck get knocked out of the way? I mean, I saw the winning puck was out there for quite a while and no one touched it, so maybe that's a strategy to go with, or You'd be one of the last ones, and maybe you could have hit that puck out of the way, and you'd be the one sitting there. But
you can see them gathering the pucks near center ice. They'll announce the winner shortly. Here it is. Oscar is the winner. That's unfortunate. Hey, congratulations, Oscar.
Yeah, way to go,
Oscar. We wish that Channel 15 would have won, but hey, we can deal with it. The girl you see at the center of the ice, I was talking to her a little bit before when we were purchasing our pucks, and she said all the donations from Chuck-a-Puck go to Centennial Girls Hockey Program, half of them. The other half of the money that's donated goes to the winner. So congratulations to the winner. We are just about set for third period action here on North Metro 15. What a second period we saw. We'll be back with more from Centennial Sports Arena after this. The Cougars won. Hill Murray, nothing. We're back here at Centennial Sports Arena in Circle Pines, Minnesota, where the Centennial Cougars are holding on to a 1-0 edge over the high-scoring attack of the Hill Murray Pioneers. And Matt, first and second period, we've seen a very aggressive play so far. The Cougars certainly stepped up in the second period, getting that first goal.
Yeah, it's been a very exciting game and a very close game. And one, oh, you can look at the, it's here. No power plays before the second period. Lots of them here so far. The Pioneers are 0 for 3. They're out shooting Centennial 27 to 11. But again, it's the shots that count. The Cougars have the only one that does. But they have a lot of penalty minutes. There's still a minute 18 left on that major penalty to Zewers.
Yeah, the penalties in that late in the period were certainly crucial. Look at the scoring summary here. Lisa Zewers, the sophomore, number 12, scoring the assist by Sakata at 4:15 in the second. That was the lone goal. The penalties, as you'll see, Monica Rawlings for holding the three penalties against the Cougars on Trinkle, Danielson, and Zewers, both coming within 3 minutes of each other in that second period. And that was a crucial point. Hill Murray had a great opportunity. We have a minute 18 to go on the major penalty that was assessed to Zewers. So for a minute 18 of this third period, the Cougars will still be shorthanded. They're going to have to hold them early.
Yeah, Hill Murray, they've had an entire intermission, you know, period time here to be able to talk about what they want to do coming out here with that power play, minute 18 left. One thing I did like by the Centennial team, what they did near the end of the period to kill it off, was they were very aggressive. They pushed strong into the Hill Murray zone to kill that off.
We are just about set to go, as you will soon see the buzzer or hear the buzzer go off. We are at the start of the third period of play, and the Centennial Cougars, who are about to make their way onto the ice here in just a second. They are just 17 minutes away from that championship trophy, and that is one of our cameramen, Tom.
He's waiting in line to
Cash, waiting in line for our drinks.
And people in the truck, so we're short camera one
right
now.
I can do camera, honestly, I promise. I can stand here. Ooh. On the side of the camera.
Okay. Double duties.
Here's a look at your Centennial Cougars. Announcer/ pan movement on camera one. That's some quality stuff right there.
Yeah, that's some nice camera operation.
Look at that.
Trying to stay on headset with me, too.
I'm doing a good job here. I miss North Metro 15. It's been a while. We'll center it right there. Leave it there for a while. There we go. Look at your Cougars, who are leading by one here at their home ice. And home ice advantage certainly has, I guess, taken shape here. But it seems kind of like the site has a pretty neutral feel to it, though, Matt, even though the Cougars are at home, just because there's a good amount of Hill Murray fans here.
Yeah, a lot of Hill Murray fans making the trip. While I have a second here, I'm going to tell you the showing times of this game that we have scheduled right now.
Sincata has 12 goals in the year, 15 assists, as we'll mention real quick. She had one last night, and just a quick look at one of the leading scorers for the Cougars. Sorry, Matt, continue.
Well, the first showing time will be at Wednesday at 9 p.m., and then Thursday it'll be shown at 1 and 7, and then on Friday it'll be shown at 11 and 9. And looks like
we now have our cameraman
back, so...
Hey, Matt, I was doing a good job. I lost my job.
Well, Matt can join me back in the booth.
All I get to do is talk. Yeah, that's great. We're back. Yeah, we're doing good. 17 minutes away from that championship trophy are your Centennial Cougars. We are about ready to go here. Opening faceoff of this crucial third period. And Centennial, unable to hold on last year, they got second place in the tournament. Certainly, they've been eyeing this trophy for a few years, and this today is certainly their best chance. They take control of the early faceoff. Cincata in front of the goal early, and look at this aggressiveness by the Cougars.
Yeah, like I said, shorthand, I like the way they did it at the end of last period. They pushed in the zone, didn't let Murray, but now Hill Murray is called for a penalty, so that really helped Centennial. So now they will not be shorthanded. It'll be 4-on-4.
Very.
And then they'll actually have a power play for about a minute.
Good point, Matt. You see that the Cougars coming out here were shorthanded early, and certainly Hill Murray had a great chance to take over momentum. And with this penalty, the Cougars and Pioneers are back to even strength and a good chance for, or excuse me, Centennial will be on the power play. Is that correct?
Yeah, Centennial will be on the power play
so
after a minute now. When Zuers' major is over.
The momentum certainly has switched. And look at this diving effort by the Cougar players, something you didn't see much of in the first two periods. Despite that one goal they got, they're playing a little bit more aggressively here in the third period, I think, early.
Yeah, and it seems like in the other two games that they wait for the third period to become very aggressive. And I expect to see a very exciting third period. Hill Murray, like we've mentioned many times, a very good offense. They're going to try and come out and tie this game up. Centennial, they're probably going to look for to try and get a two-goal lead to get a little bit of a cushion against this offense.
I see call coming with 16:11 to go in the third period clock here from the home of the Centennial Cougars, the Centennial Sports Arena. 4-on-4 now again for another 29 seconds. And then the Cougars will go on that power play, as we mentioned, in a very crucial power play. Just about as crucial as this faceoff is here. They need to take control.
Yeah, Centennial in the second period did a good job of controlling faceoffs, especially in their own zone. They somewhat managed to control this one. They're up against the boards.
Both teams fighting for the control of the puck right now. Centennial, again, you know, they get rid of the puck once, and now they finally are able to take control. It looks like their offense is a little bit more organized than it was in the first two periods. They did score that one goal off of a rebound. Lisa Zuers, the goal came at 4:15 in the second.
Yeah,
Hill Murray. The Cougars are on the power play.
Hill Murray still isn't giving them a great chance of setting anything up, though, but like you said, they seem to be a little bit better here early in this period than they had in the other two periods.
The power play, certainly a good chance for the Cougars to extend their lead, and certainly it'd be huge to have a two-goal lead with just a period to go. So Centennial looking to open things up a little bit. They got that first goal, that important goal that they needed, and now they're trying to open it up.
Well, not only did they use the power play to try and get a goal, here in this third period, time is very precious to Hill Murray, and every second they're on the power play, that's a second they're every second they're shorthanded, they don't get a chance or as good of a chance to score a goal. So it's like an extra defense for Centennial.
There was a trip, nothing called. Hill Murray fans a little bit upset, as you saw that on the right side of your screen, and now Hill Murray will clear once again. We have
offside penalty,
I believe.
Yeah, it was delayed offsides right there. Pretty intentional. She knew that there's no way she was going to be.
Pioneers at full strength now, though we will have a faceoff coming for the offside. And we are just over the 14-minute mark now here in period number three. The Cougars in front of the Hill Murray goal, but the Pioneers cleared out successfully along the near side. Centennial will try to clear it back across their end and set up their offense as both teams change lines.
Yeah, one thing to really look for Centennial in this period, what they're going to try and do here throughout this entire period, as long as they have this one goal lead, is every
That one almost slipped through the legs of Alana McCready, and an unexpected shot there. I believe that was Katie Lawler taking the shot number 9, and she cruises down the other end of the ice to try and set things up again. I think that was Lawler. What a play.
Yeah, McCready, she tried to freeze that puck and it just sort of dribbled down and nearly squeaked through. She's made so many great saves.
Wow! Lawler again trying to move the puck up the ice, and here comes number 28 for the Cougars, Melissa Shemileski, without her stick, looking to lay a hit on, and she will step off the ice now. Lawler got drilled. The Cougars' aggressiveness has certainly stepped up.
Lawler got hit so hard, Shemileski broke her stick. That's why she doesn't have it. Half it's laying out in the Centennial zone right there.
And out of the net, they need to get a shot up here, but getting back is McCree. That was a very, very dangerous spot. She was out of the crease and got back just in time, so the Pioneers could not get an open look at the net. You can't give anything up, especially mistakes like that.
Ellison, right there, the referees didn't blow the whistle that early when McCree tried to cover like they had when Centennial was shorthanded in the second period. I had mentioned that there's a couple of quick whistles on Friesen, so maybe the referees were talked to by the Hill Murray coach and said, you know, don't blow it so quick for us.
The Cougar passing, very impressive, even now that both teams are at full strength. Before, their passing was great. They were very aggressive on the power play. And, oh, there has to be a call. Nothing is called. The girl on the far left here, screen number five there behind the net now for Hill Murray, was drilled, but nothing called. The referee's letting him play, and now we may have an offside.
Well, it was going to be a delayed offside. The Centennial would have touched it first, but since they didn't, they wave it off. A little bit of a dive there I saw by and
a lot of McCready, 29 saves, and that's how the Cougars are holding on to their 1-0 lead. If you're just joining us, Centennial with 12 shots on goal, they have that one goal. The goal coming in the second period at 4:15 from Lisa Zewers, as Brookshaw for Hill Murray covers it up, and with just under 12 minutes to go, Matt, 29 saves for McCready, and certainly she's had her work cut out for her all game. How? Here's a look at that takedown that we saw earlier. We'll go back to McCready in a second.
That takedown was sort of just on both, you know. Hill Murray initiated the contact. Centennial is just, I mean, they both went down. It wasn't like either one of them, so.
Yeah, I think the refs were just saying, hey, it was even, so we won't call anything. But as I was talking about McCready, she's got to be getting tired pretty soon. I know she had a long night last night with the shootout and everything, but I talked to Coach Vogt before.
Actually,
the game.
Actually, that was two nights ago.
I'm sorry. I keep thinking. I was talking to Coach Vogt. I was talking to Coach Vogt about that and about the endurance of the team. He said that she was excited to have, you know, the shootout, a long game. It's something a goalie always looks forward to, and certainly she played very well. The Cougars won that, but you have to imagine here, she's had 29 saves. You got to leave her in the game, obviously, but, you know, one's going to slip through pretty soon.
Yeah. Well, with Vold saying that she liked that shootout, that's a big sign of saying that she likes the game on her shoulders. She wants to carry this team to victory. And when you got a goaltender that wants to do that.
Oh, strike three. She misses the puck. Number nine for Centennial, Kaylee Nelson, trying to take a shot. Just slipped out of her hands a little bit. I believe that's who it was. But a good effort from the Cougars trying to get something going offensively, but she just couldn't quite hold on.
Well, Kaylee Nelson, she's had a very nice tournament here. Three goals, that leads the Centennial team. And
she was looking for number four right there.
Yeah, one of her goals came in one of the shootouts last night. I believe it was the second shootout she got. So, but yeah, Mara McCready, I mean, when a goaltender says that she likes the shootouts, that means she likes the pressure. And how much more pressure is this? You know, 11 minutes left, basically. Every shot on her is important.
Very true. It's a championship game. I've played in some championship games myself and in other sports, and it's definitely, you know, a very big emotional aspect of the game you have to look out for. You know, these teams are coming into this game with all their heart and all their soul, playing with everything they've got, and they want this more than anything. And certainly the Cougars playing like it right now. Hill Murray, though, still staying strong as they look to set up their offense.
Yeah. And no matter which team wins this game,
they get a shot! The save! The rebound! And McCready will hold on!
She snagged that one right out of the air. She got lucky that no Hill Murray player tried to take a swing at that puck in the air and maybe caught her with a stick, but she snagged it right in the air with her glove. Great save again. She just, every time Hill Murray comes knocking, she shuts the door on him.
She'll have to do it again here as Hill Murray will take the faceoff in the Cougars zone, but again, Centennial controls the faceoff. That is something that they've definitely worked on between Saturday night's game and today. They definitely have improved in that department. Just over 10 to go now, third period of play from Centennial.
Yeah, faceoffs in the third period is going to be very important because, again, like I said, time is right now Centennial's best friend. The more they can manage to take off by getting pucks pinned up against the board or controlling the faceoffs and not letting Hill-Murray touch it, is all the better for them.
Hill-Murray, the last 2 minutes, has definitely controlled their offense. We've seen a lot of play down here in the Cougar end. So, Hill-Murray definitely still playing aggressive. They know they're still in this game. All they are is one shot away from tying this one up, and you never know. We could see overtime again. They'll take a shot here, and it's pretty wide. Just trying to clear it out, looking for a pass there, and Colleen Conway couldn't quite find one.
I think that shot was a little bit deflected. I think what she wanted to do was get that shot onto McCready. She had a skater trailing for that, where the rebound normally goes to the open side of the net. If the shot would have got onto McCready, I think Hill-Murray would have had a goal right there.
Very good point, Matt. And we have a stoppage of play here. There will be a face-off coming now with 9.5 to go in the third. In the Cougar zone, Hill-Murray with a chance to tie. The Cougars controlled it for a second, but Hill-Murray just got it back. They try to set up their offense in front of the net. No one there. The pass came from Courtney Sekovic again, who's had a pretty good game. The shot, the rebound, misses. The rebound, nothing there. McCready is on fire.
Oh, she has something watching over her tonight right now. One puck hit off the post and went through the crease. The other one was free, and Hill-Murray just swung and missed on it.
Matt,
on open
look at
net.
This. Here's Sekovic. She gets the initial pass. They try to get something working in front of the net. Sekovic comes all the way back around herself, and here she gets a pass up from number three. She's right there in the left part of your screen. I believe she had an open shot in front of the net. Couldn't quite get it to go in. An amazing break for Centennial.
Yeah, Alana McCready, if Centennial wins this tournament, no doubt about it, one gets player of the game, and I think player of the tournament.
I completely agree with you. A tournament we've seen a very good job of the Cougar defense. They've held Hill-Murray to no goals through 2.5 periods of play. A team that averages 8 goals a game in their wins, and McCready is there again.
And a Hill-Murray player is down.
Is the ice melting?
Number
she's hot.
Jessica Murphy, she is down on the ice right now.
Look at this again. McCready has had an amazing game. Look at this. How does she do it? What a play.
I don't know. It's like she seems, she has like, what do you call it? Being able to see into the future of where that puck's going to be every time. She's always in the right place.
8.5 to go. We have a penalty. And it's 2 minutes for holding, did I hear? It's on number 5.
I think it was
Cougars.
Elbowing.
Elbowing, yes, you're correct. It's Amy Danielson, the penalty.
Yeah.
Number 5 for the Cougars, the junior, and big chance for Hill-Murray.
She ended up knocking down Jessica Murphy, and she was down for about a minute after they blew the whistle. But Centennial, again, they've done a very good job this entire tournament on penalty kills. And, whoa! And I saw Gindin throw down a Hill-Murray player. I don't think the refs saw it. They were watching the puck, and the Hill-Murray player was having a little bit of trouble getting up after that.
Do you think they want this game or what? Look at the aggressiveness. You see it there from our camera. Great job by Mike Roller down there on the camera, giving us that shot. And the Cougars, aggressiveness is stepping up with 7.5 to go. They need something. They're playing like they want it.
Yeah.
Last night they played well, but certainly not this aggressive.
No, and not this physical either. They were both this physical in the first game, but they hadn't had it dished out against them as much as they have in this game. And earlier you saw that play up against the boards. I would have had to say that was 2 points for a takedown, but we're not watching wrestling.
Easy stop there. Clean Kama got a little bit of a shot off, but pretty no problem grabbing it with the glove. And just 38 seconds to go on the power play. 7:09 to go in the game. Centennial holding on to the 1-0 lead. And Hill-Murray on the power play. They need to take advantage here in the next 38 seconds.
Yeah. And with how, I mean, there's been 33 shots for Hill-Murray. Not one has gone through. I still can't say enough about McCready. Even if she does give up a goal, I still think she has to be player of the tournament. There's no way.
You're definitely right, Matt. I think certainly this is one of the higher amount of goals she's had shot against her this season in this tournament as well. And with 6.5 minutes to go, Hill-Murray will certainly get a few more shots off, and she's going to have to keep playing aggressive just as she has all tournament long, all season long. Again, her goal is against average is under two. And today and yesterday, she, you know, it wasn't until about this point in last night's game where she gave up her first goal. So Alana McCree certainly a candidate. They're now back to full strength, and they will try to score themselves to open this game up with 6.5 to go.
Well, in this tournament, McCready, she's only given up one in each game, only one goal in regulation. The other goal she gave up last night was in that shootout. So, I mean, really, she's only allowed one goal a game so far in this tournament. So far, none in this one. And you see her goals allowed average is just about 1.6. So, you know, once in a, you know, she gives up one goal one game, two goals another game.
And the Cougars lose control of the puck. Hilberg gets back in the Cougars zone. McCready is there again. Are you surprised? There's a little bit of pushing and shoving going on after the shot there, but nothing called, and McCready.
Yeah, McCready gets got back fell up. On by a Hilmari player. You can watch the replay here. That McCready player for Hilmari was Cat.
The Cougar skate almost put it in. Number 23 there for Centennial had a skate, and then a player just topples over.
Well, you saw Cat. She got cross-checked a little bit at the end of the play. No call. And Centennial, I'm not going to say that they've been playing dirty, but they have been playing very aggressive, and this entire tournament they've had a lot of penalties called on them.
And it's going both ways. I mean, Hilbury's playing very aggressive as well, and that's certainly what you expect in a game of this caliber. It's a very intense battle, and still anybody's game with just a one-goal lead for the Cougars. They certainly are hoping to extend that lead. Hilbury, both teams again at full strength now with under six to go. Behind the Centennial net, they will try to get the puck out of the zone. Right, defense is going to have to win the championship, Matt.
Yes. And like you're saying, it does go both ways. In the first period, I saw a lot of hits by Hilmari that weren't called. And just like here by Centennial, you saw a little bit of a trip there against Sincata. And the referees, they're letting them play. They don't want to control this game. I mean, if it's blatant or dangerous, obviously they're going
to
call it.
Sincata, a wraparound that actually hit close to the pipe. Decent shot from behind the net. She couldn't find a pass in front, so took it upon herself. And now, look at the puck handling by number 16 for Hilmari, Nicole Rawlings. Oh, that was amazing. She weaves through two defenders.
Yeah, she's obviously one of the better players for Hilmari with 10 goals on this season. So, and Hilmari, they have a lot of people to look for, where Centennial, they're going to have to stick with defense the rest of this game.
It is crunch time as you see a crunch right in front of us.
And you heard that big hit on our shotgun mics. Great placement for those right there.
We talk about crunch, we see a crunch. Amazing. These teams are just playing so aggressive. We have another whistle here, and the aggressiveness is going to...
That's
going to
be offsides right there, actually. I saw Hilmari. They almost kept it on, but it just crossed the blue line when one of the Hilmari players was on the ice.
Centennial Cougars, 5.
The Centennial Cougars boys hockey team, as we just heard over the PA system, lead Elk River 5-2 at the Xcel Energy Center in the tournament that used to be held here. Centennial up 5-2 over Elk River.
You saw more physical play right there, this time by the big... Sekovic. I'm sorry.
Yep,
yes,
right.
Sekovic. A little difficult to pronounce, but she's the big goal scorer. You know, one of the players with 10, and she had a big hit right there. So
the Cougars transition, and they will get a shot. No goal! Excellent stop by Brookshaw, who has to hold on. The Hilbury defenders helping her out with 4 minutes to go. Centennial just broke out of the defense and had a shot. Great passing.
Yeah, I think the rest of this period, those are going to be the types of opportunities Centennial is going to have, if they have any, are those types of ones. They aren't going to really put too many defense people in on offense because they don't want to give up an odd skater break the other way around.
Hilmari now down in the Cougar zone. The 3.5 to go. A long shot from the blue line. And I don't know how that one got through the two defenders, but we have a player down on the ice, and it's number 10.
Oh, she looks hurt. That's number 10, Jamie Buskirk. And
she
got hit hard. You can see you see lots of hitting this whole period. Lots of hitting. But, I mean, that was just...
She was rocked by Tina Toffoli, the senior forward who's in the game now for Centennial. She didn't start tonight, but she has definitely had some good minutes.
I've seen less hitting in a Wild game. all that's going to be left here is
Wild,
maybe one of these girls are going to drop the
losing
glove.
Record. Maybe the Wild need to be a little more aggressive.
Oh, the Wild aren't doing so bad right now.
3 minutes and 12 seconds to go on our third period clock. Hill Murray still trailing by one. They're going to need a late game heroic from someone to get them back in this game. In front of the net, a dangerous spot. The Cougar defense is there. Sincana all over, and she gets pushed hard by Kristen Peterson. Kirsten.
Yeah, Sincana, she kept Kirsten Peterson down a couple of times there. And I heard Hill Murray fans really wanting a call.
They have a chance here. They have a chance here, but the Cougar defense. Look who it is. Sincana is all over the place.
Well, Sincana's their leader. She's going to be the one that, I mean, she's a senior. She's going to really want this tournament, and they look to her.
Sincana is on defense. She's on offense. She's just a star tonight. All over the place. That puck was a dangerous bounce off of McCready. The Pioneers had a chance but couldn't quite get the shot off the rebound, and they'll try to set up their offense once again. Just over 2 minutes to go.
Oh!
Just wide. The Hill Murray fans on their feet.
Yeah, that was very close. A screen out in front of McCready. We're down to about 2 minutes left, and I've seen a lot of stuff that should be called by these referees that have not. Someone might get hurt with all this.
They
hitting.
Need to change lines quickly. Centennial taking too much time to get back in the ice. That gives Fletcher time to take the shot, and the save. McCready is there. What a play! The Cougars took way too long to change their lines. It gave Fletcher a chance. She's a defender, and she came all the way down the ice. Let's take another look. There's no Cougars around her. Fletcher by herself, number 5. You take a shot here. Boom!
Well, one thing right there with Hill Murray needing chances, they elected not to take their line change at the same time. And here they ended up taking it right after the freeze. They saw an opportunity. They knew that they need as many as they can get, so they decided that maybe a couple more seconds of skating isn't going to hurt them, and they had a very good chance there. But
Centennial
McCready,
takes a timeout.
41 saves. 41 saves in a high school.
Hey, want to do YMCA? I'm sorry. No. 41 saves is awesome. It's not as awesome as we need to do the YMCA. Come on, man. You can do it.
I'm not much of a dancer. I'm sorry. I won't stop you, though. But we got a timeout here, so.
The Cougars trying to take a little time off. Are you ready for YMCA?
You take it away.
Are you ready? Come on, man. We need you.
No, I think we should get the camera to take a look at this.
Oh, we got James Magnuson over there.
And you can see Matt right there. He's ready to.
There's no Y yet. Here it comes.
See a couple of Centennial fans also dancing. They're getting into it there. They're enjoying this one goal lead with a minute 48 left. And they're hoping to hold on here with a faceoff going in the Centennial zone. Down or up one is Centennial.
A replay now we're going to take a look at of the Centennial goal as we try to focus back on a very crucial point of the hockey game.
Now this is, that was probably the best save I've seen this entire tournament.
Thank you for showing us a save, gentlemen. We appreciate the shot of the save.
Yeah, I would have to say that is the play of the tournament right
definitely
there.
Under two to go. Fletcher from the blue line.
Oh,
excellent shot.
There was a deflection right there by Hillman, and if she would have let that through, McCready would have had to get down really quick to stop that. She did not go down, and Matt, it was heading right.
Fletcher's all over the puck again. It's been one-on-one all night. There should have been a holding call there. Fletcher still taking control, tries to get in front of the net. They get the board. And Hill Murray playing aggressive in the last 2 minutes, Matt. They are on fire right now, and they need to keep that aggressiveness going for another 73 seconds.
And there's about a minute left. Once Hill Murray gets in the zone, luck towards Hill Murray pulling their goalie.
A minute to go in the game, and what a game it has been. The Cougars holding on to a 1-0 lead.
There's going to be an icing here. With 51 seconds left, we might see the goalie pulled. She didn't even motion towards the bench here. Maybe the Hill Murray coach doesn't want to give up an empty net goal, figuring that his offense, good as it is, couldn't get a goal here with 51 seconds left.
So. He should be pretty confident in his offense, who averages, you know, 8 goals a game in their victories. And they only have 3 losses this season. And in those 3 losses,
and
they have
here's
very
another
few
timeout, this
goals
time
left.
By Hill Murray. What one thing I'd like to mention is we've been talking so much about McCready. I think we should also give Brookshaw her due She's had an amazing game. The one goal she did give up, I do not feel is completely her fault. Her defense did not clear the puck when it was in this, when it was in the crease. Her defense did not get it out of there. So, I mean, we've been talking so much about McCree. We can't forget about Brookshaw. She's also had a good tournament, only giving up 3 goals before this game, so 4, including this game. You see, again, the same 2 Centennial fans at the YFCA, they...
1-0, the Cougars holding on.
The one goal lead with 51 to go in the third, as you can see in our graphic there. We're going to tell you how Canada has anything to do with the graphics that we provide here for you at North Metro 15. The squash box is the score box that you see in the top left corner of your screen when the game is in action. And that comes to us from the one and only Saskatoon, Saskatchewan, Canadian native, Mr. Matt Waldron. That debuted in the 2002 USA Cup, the Schwann's USA Cup that we covered. Hundreds of hockey games. We covered about 37 of them, I believe, and Matt Waldron was the man. And you will see our squatch box come up. It's been there forever. There it is. The squatch box. Thank you, Matt. We love you.
Sincata took that draw. She didn't control, but again, didn't give a free draw to Hill Murray.
Comes Fletcher, the shot through the defense, and the Cougars are there.
Nice deflection right there.
Centennial will move the puck across
the ice. They're going to try and take up as much time as possible here. They get it deep into Hill Murray's zone. With 30 seconds left, Hill Murray has to make a move here. Sincata fighting for it along the boards. This is exactly what Centennial needs, as much time in the zone.
And Hill Murray down in their own zone. They still have not pulled the goalie, and they now will. But is there enough time for them to get a shot off? Here they come. It's Clint Conway. Back to Skakowski, the hero. Can they put it in with 5 to go?
Sincata's going to try and take up all the rest of this.
They
and
clear it.
Centennial
wins
with a shutout. 42 saves for Alana McCready. Again, player of the game, player of the tournament. She was amazing. I can't say enough about her job tonight and the whole tournament.
Ladies and gentlemen, your 2003 Centennial Holiday Classic Tournament Champions, the Centennial Cougars, the host of the tournament. They are the champions. This year, they do not come up short. They defeat a very, very talented Hill Murray team. 1-0. 42 saves from Alana McCready. Wow. What can you say?
Hill Murray has nothing to be ashamed of. They played very well, but Alana McCready, she was infallible. There was nothing she could do wrong tonight. Any time that she didn't completely make the perfect save, somehow that puck just got out of the crease around the net. Nothing got in for her. I don't know how she did it.
Alana McCready, as you take a look at her there, with 42 saves. She got one there at the end, apologize. Alana McCready, 42 saves. The player of the game, the player of the tournament, the player of the season.
Yeah.
The Cougars will improve to 12-1-1. What a game for Centennial as they win their own tournament.
And again, McCready is a sophomore. Centennial has a lot to look forward to here in the next couple of years. If you got goaltending like that, it nearly doesn't matter what other skaters you have around. If she can make 41 saves, I don't care how many. If they can play like that, like I said, you can win with just about any team.
The Hill Murray Pioneers will now be receiving their second place medals. And a great effort put forth by the Pioneers. They fall to 9-4 of the season.
And you saw right there the goalkeepers, they had a huge battle. Actually, the goalie that first came out there, she was not the one that faced Alana McCready tonight. It was, again, Emily Brookshaw, a senior. She's obviously going to be missed after this season by Hill Murray. She's done a great job in this tournament and in this game. I mean, everybody has great play for everybody on this team, and you see some great sportsmanship here. Obviously, Hill Murray's a little bit disappointed not coming out. But.
You know, Matt, the Hill Murray Pioneers, you can come into this game and you say they're 9-3. The Cougars are, well, Hill Murray came into this game 9-3. Centennial came in 11-1-1. And you think to yourself, Centennial should have the edge. But really, the way that we've seen Hill Murray play the last couple of games, especially in this tournament, and the somewhat sloppy play of the Cougars last night, or excuse me, Saturday night,
it was pretty much a push. And it, coming into this game, we knew it was going to be close. Peterson. We knew that Hill Murray had a strong offensive attack, but the Cougars had one of the better defenses, so it was going to be offense versus defense, as, you know, the defense won. Defense wins championships.
Yeah, both teams really stepped up in this game. And Centennial, I was sort of harping on them about the way that they'd been playing the first couple games. And they, you know, allowing the puck in their zone too much. Again, it was in their zone too much tonight, both McCready. And they did it. You know, they Centennial stepped up when it counted. They didn't miss their opportunity, where Hill Murray missed a couple of their opportunities offensively, and Centennial did not miss theirs at all.
It's good to see the sportsmanship, as you mentioned again, as every second place medal is distributed to the Pioneers, a Cougar player comes over and congratulates them. Great job, Centennial, winning their own tournament at home. And again, their medal presentation will take place in a few seconds. The last few years, Centennial has been on the other side. They've been receiving their medals first. But tonight, they get to wait patiently to celebrate their first place finish.
Yeah, and you saw a lot of that big hitting, the strong aggressive play by Centennial and Hill Murray. And it's nice to see that they aren't carrying any of that over. They left it, you know, on the ice during the game. You know, it doesn't seem that really have any hard feelings.
Please come forward to receive their second place trophy.
And we will have, I believe, the trophy presentation now for your.
Well, this is the second place.
Oh, okay.
Second place trophy.
Thank you.
And the captain's taking it is Valerie Rodriguez and Kelsey Fletcher.
Kelsey Fletcher, in the last 3 minutes of that game, if Hill Murray would have came up to tie that at the last second, she would have had to have been the player of the game for them. But she still is. I mean, Kelsey Fletcher's had a great game, number 5 in the green. She played very aggressively towards the end and had a few shots on goal that were so close to going in. She gave her team a chance.
Yeah, she's listed as a defensive player, and that's what she started at. But she stepped up late as an offensive player, and she is a junior, will be back next year. And with Hill Murray has a lot of returning players, like we said, only 4 seniors, and two of them are their goalies. One of them, Brookshaw, and the other one, Catelyn Daly. So, you know, they're going to have to replace their goalies, but their skaters are going to, a lot of them are going to return, and they have a lot to look forward to next year.
Centennial, as we watch them receive their first place medals, they've just beat Hill Murray tonight. They got another game coming up. They have a almost a month off before they play Irondale, I guess. I don't know if that's correct, but it looks like they have a pretty long break. But the Cougars certainly, you know, they got the North Suburban Conference schedule coming up, and it'll be a tough season. But Centennial's atop the conference right now with that 12-1-1 record, and they got a lot to look forward to.
We see Kelly Nelson right there. She had a great tournament again. No goals tonight, but she did have 3 in the tournament. So, but I'd have to say, offensively, one of the best. Zuer is obviously offensively the player tonight. But
Lisa scored the only goal.
Cincata all season long in this tournament, they looked to her to lead when they needed it. She got the game tying goal last night. She made all the draws, great defensive plays in this game, and she also helped set up that Zuer's goal.
Very, very true, Matt. And you know, every single player for this Cougar team has played so much more aggressive than they have. You know, last night, White Bear Lake, a team that was pretty tough. Hill Murray actually beat White Bear Lake earlier in the season, 5-3. The Cougars lost them earlier in the season, but last night got revenge in that shootout. And now the Cougars come back today after a somewhat sloppy win on Saturday. And tonight come out strong and beat a team that, you know, a lot of skeptics, including ourselves, weren't sure if they could pull it off. But they did it with the help of their defense.
Yeah, I'd watched Hill Murray earlier in this tournament, and they looked very strong. And listen to the cheering for Alana McCree. She deserves it very much. And there she gets met by the captains and the other goaltender.
She is.
And you saw some great sportsmanship. They said, you know, pretty much, when you saw Fletcher out there, I'm sure saying, great job. You know, that this game is because of you that they won it.
Alana McCree is our North Metro 15 player of the game, and your Centennial Cougars are the Centennial Holiday Tournament champions, as you take one last look at the Cougars there. Centennial now, again, as you mentioned, improves to 12-1-1. Hill Murray falls to 9-4 following the loss, and congratulations to the Centennial Cougars
as they slide safely.
See him celebrating right there.
Don't drop the trophy. Don't drop the trophy.
Yeah.
Look at them.
Now they still have a little bit of a season left, and they go hopefully in the state, and maybe the momentum they have in this tournament, knowing how to finally win a tournament.
This helps them to gain some confidence and momentum going into the next stretch of the season. The postseason coming up in just a few short months. March is not too far away. Late February and March when the tournament start. Centennial's certainly a contender, especially in the North Suburban Conference. You know, that strong 12-1-1 record is going to help them out in a pretty decent conference where Chisago Lakes, Wright County, and Irondale all have winning records. So they have a few more games left that are going to be tough coming up early. And, you know, what else can you say? A great effort by both teams.
I know I've said a lot, but if Lana McCurdy can play like this every night, no one will ever beat Centennial this season again.
The Cougars on fire, and good luck to them as well as the Hill Murray Pioneers in the remainder of their season. For everyone here at North Metro 15, Mike Roller, Tommy Cash, James Magnuson, Mike Androwski, everybody in the truck, Kenton Kipp and Matt Waldron.
Stop, Matt.
Have Androwski. A good night. Matt Androwski. What did I say?
You said Mike.
We're done. The
it's
lights are out. We're done. There's
folks.
No, we can't see. Good night.
It's been
from
a
North
long
Metro
tournament.
15.
Minnesota Media Archive is brought to you by North Metro TV. Your support helps make the archive possible. If you like this video, please consider a one-time donation.